Shalom, shalom, shalom. All praises, honor, and glory goes to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai Bahashem Rakai Kadash. Double honor city apostles, double honor city elders, a great millstone. Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, break a thumb to the whole full elect. Shalom, shalom. Back one more lesson, man. Today's video is going to be entitled Betrayal is a Reality in the Truth. Betrayal is a harsh reality in the truth. You know, just continuing the theme of this week, going into the Passover, we're going to be reading John chapter 13, you know, going into the night Yahweh Shai was betrayed. And, you know, Yahweh Shai's betrayal by Judas Iscariot is really an example of how, you know, like I say, that harsh reality could be made manifest, and it could be made manifest in each and every brother's lives, man. See what I'm saying? And when I speak of betrayal, I'm not always speaking of just, you know, a brother in the camp, because we know that's a possibility. We know that there's men, you know, that don't do the work of the Lord out of sincerity. There's men that aren't sincere. There's men who just straight up are not of the elect. But, you know, that betrayal is bigger than just, you know, the brother in the camp. It could be family members. Because the scriptures say, you know, Yahweh Shai say he come to bring division, and a man's foes shall be they of his own household. It could be people you cool with, co-workers. You know what I'm saying? People you know in the world. You know, because at the end of the day, you know, you know, when I'm in my Clark Kent mode, hey, I consider myself a likable guy. You know, there's people that's cool with me. There's people I keep around for, you know, certain favors and whatnot. But at the end of the day, all that shit is fake love. You know, you got to consider all of that fake love, because at a certain point of time, you know, people are going to be willing to give you up for any and every benefit they can get, especially in the time of Jacob's trouble. Man, let me turn the fan on. It's getting a little hot.
Waiting for Perry.
1 second. Getting a little hot. But like I say, in the time of Jacob's trouble, people are going to be willing to betray you for any little thing, whether it's to you know, save their own lives, save their kids' lives, to put food in their stomach. People will be willing to do any and everything. So you can't put that past any one certain person. You can't put it past your own kids. You can't put it past, you know, the fucking chick you smashing two or three times a week. You know, you may be giving her the best ride she ever had in her life, but when it come down to life and death, she gonna be willing to give your ass up, man. You know what I'm saying? Co-workers, I don't care how many times you didn't, you know, chopped it up about the Chiefs game and did all that shit. You know, at the end of the day, when it come down to certain decisions, they're going to be willing to give you up. You see? So that's why, you know, title of this lesson, Betrayal is a Harsh Reality We Have to Deal With, man. Don't take none of this in this video to, like I say, when I do lessons like this, I always say this. Don't make this as a reason to look at brothers sideways, man, because ultimately, we don't know who that lot is going to fall upon. We just got to pray that Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai doesn't have that lot fall upon us. Because even though Yahweh Shai knew Judas was going to betray him, the rest of the 11, they didn't know. They were still treating Judas like a brother. Judas was eating chicken. Judas was pouring up wine. Judas was cracking jokes with everybody else. But he did have a satanic spirit on him, man. So let's just get right into it. Lord willing, this video edifying. This John chapter 13, verse 1. It says, now before the feast of the Passover, when Yahweh Shai knew that his hour was come, that he should depart out of this world unto the Father, having loved his own which were in the world. Look, see, loved his own. Hey, that's going into the elect. Because guess what? A lot of niggas hated Yahweh Shai. Yahweh Shai did not have no love for them, man. Let's read again. Now, before the feast of the Passover, when Yahweh Shai knew what his hour was come, that he should depart out of this world unto the Father, having loved his own which were in the world, he loved them unto the end. And supper being ended, the devil, having now put into the heart of Judas Iscariot, Simon's son, to betray him. You see, Satan had access to the mind of Judas Iscariot, man. Now, we can't say whatever reason. Ultimately, it's because Yahweh Bashem Yahshua wanted that lot to fall upon him. But we just got to pray to Yahweh Bashem Yahshua once again that lot doesn't fall upon us and stay rooted in Yahweh Shah so we can be, you know, have that Ephesians 6, have that whole armor against the wiles of the devil. But once again, these people in the world, they could be easily taken over by Satan. We was just mentioning that at camp, like the movie with the Matrix. You see, everybody who's not unplugged could be a potential agent. And you saw that. Everybody, you know, it would be a random, you know, fine-ass looking blonde girl, you know, the woman in the red dress, but she turned into fucking, Agent Smith out of nowhere, man. And you got to take that with the world, man. Like I say, that go to the fucking chick you smashing. That go to your parents, your siblings. You know what I'm saying? Even your own kids, even your coworkers, man. If they not unplugged from this matrix, they could be an agent, man. But it say, John 13:3, Yahweh Shah, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, that he was come from the Most High and went to the Most High. He riseth from supper and laid aside his garments and took a towel and girded himself. After that, he poureth water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel wherewith he was girded. Then cometh he to Simon Peter, and Peter saith unto him, Lord, dost thou wash my feet? Yahweh Shah answered and said unto him, What I do thou knowest not now, but thou shalt know hereafter. Peter saith unto him, Thou shalt never wash my feet. Yahweh Shah answered him, If I wash thee not, thou hast no part with me. Simon Peter saith unto him, Lord, not my feet only, but only wash my hands and my head. Yahweh Shah saith unto him, He that is washed needed not to save, Slaki. He that is washed needed not save to wash his feet, but is clean every whit, and ye are clean, but not all. See, hey, Yahweh Shah was bringing that pressure. You know, Yahweh Shah was causing that tension in the room. He said, but it's clean every whit, but ye are clean, but not all. For he knew who should betray him. Therefore said he, Ye are not all clean. So after he had washed their feet and had taken his garment and was sat down again, he said unto them, Know ye what I have done to you? Ye call me master and Lord, and ye say, Well, for so I am. If I then, your Lord and master, have washed your feet, ye ought to wash one another's feet. Hey, and that's good exhortation on how to deal with brothers, man. Going into the first video I did this week, man, if you got alt with brothers, hey, man, you're supposed to squash that, because no matter how you feel, you're supposed to be able to wash that man's feet. And washing somebody's feet is a very submissive move. You know, that's something like servants do. So, hey, we're supposed to serve each other, man. Yahweh Shah said so. It say, John chapter 13, verse 14. It says, If I then, your Lord and master, have washed your feet, ye also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have given you an example that ye should do as I have done to you. Verily, verily, I say unto you, the servant is not greater than his Lord, neither he that is sent greater than he that sent him. If ye know these things, happy are ye if ye do them. I speak not of you all. I know whom I have chosen, but that the scripture may be fulfilled, he that eateth bread with me hath lifted up his heel against me. See, that's Yahweh Shah creating that tension. Now I tell you before it come, that when it come to pass, ye may believe that I am he. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that receiveth whomsoever I sendeth receiveth me, and he that receiveth me receiveth him that sent me. Which makes us ambassadors for Yahweh Shah, man. So when the people in this world reject us, not only going to these women, but going when we out on the highways and byways, and you know, certain people in our personal lives, when they reject us, when they speak evil of us, they're rejecting and speaking evil of Yahweh, man. And, you know, I've been having some personal testimonies of some people at my job talking shit, or at least, you know, treating me a certain type of way, and the Lord judged they ass, man. You know, I may get into it, into some lessons, but it ain't really like major testimonies. But hey, the Lord judging these people who be talking shit, you know, behind Jake back, man. You know, he don't like that, man. Hey, 144. Call all Yahweh by Shema Shai. But continuing, John 13, verse 20. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that receiveth whomsoever I send it, receiveth me. And he that receiveth me, receiveth him that sent me. When Yahweh thus said, he was troubled in spirit and testified and said, verily, verily, I say unto you, that one of you shall betray me. Say, Yahweh was troubled in spirit, because even though he knew Judas was going to betray him, he still had to hold it in, man. He still kept his peace about it. But now it was coming to the point where he was going to be betrayed, and it was troubling him because he knew what type of hell he was going to catch behind Judas's actions. Even though it don't always fall on Judas, because the scripture had to be fulfilled, but Judas was a catalyst for that to happen. The same way the scripture say we're going to be martyrs, we're going to be hated amongst men, the Lord is going to pick certain people for that lot to fall upon, man. Like I said, it may be your girl, it may be your parents, it may be your children, it may be your co-workers, it may be people you know in the world, it may be a brother in the camp. You see, this is just the harsh reality that comes with this truth, betrayal. It say, when Yahweh thus said, he was troubled in spirit and testified and said, verily, verily, I say unto you, that one of you shall betray me. Then the disciples looked one on another, doubting of whom he spake, right? Because they think they all tight. We all done ate chicken and lamb together. We done seen miracles together. We done drank wine together. We all walked with Yahweh Shah. They like, man, who the fuck is it? It said, now there was a leaning on Yahweh Shah's bosom, one of his disciples, whom Yahweh Shah loved. Simon Peter therefore beckoned to him that he should ask who it should be of whom he spake. He then, lying on Yahweh Shah's breast, saith unto him, Lord, who is it? Yahweh Shah answered, he it is to whom I shall give a sop when I have dipped it. And when he had dipped the sop, he gave it to Judas Iscariot, the son of Simon. And after the sop, Satan entered into him. Satan entered him. Then Yahweh Shah said unto him, that thou doest, do quickly. And that's one of the coldest lines in the Bible, man. It said, that thou doest, do quickly. Do what thou doest quickly, man. It says, now no man at the table knew for what intent he spake this unto him. For some of them thought, because Judas had the bag, that Yahweh Shah had said unto him, buy those things that we have needest against the feast, or that he should give something to the poor. He then, having received the sop, went immediately out, and it was night. We know what Judas did after that. He betrayed Yahweh Shah, man. But, you know, I'm gonna leave it at that. I ain't gonna read too much. But, you know, I just wanted to, you know, remind brothers of what we up against, man. Like I say, you know, we all got different personalities. Some people is more antisocial. Some people are kind of like me, you know, they likable, you know what I'm saying, whatnot. Even though we don't want to be partakers in the world, but we know how to fit in with the world. But at the end of the day, we can't get comfortable with any of this shit. Anybody that you cool with that's not in the truth, they could betray you, man. Even, once again, this could even fall upon the lot of a brother in the truth. Now, once again, we want to pray that doesn't fall upon us, but it's a possibility. And we wouldn't be telling you the truth if we didn't go into things like this. But with that, Lord willing, this is edifying. All praises, honor, and glory. It goes Yahweh by Shem Yahweh Shai, by Shem Kakadash. Double honor to the apostles. Double honor to the elders of Great Millstone. Yahweh by Shem Yahweh Shai, bracket thumb to the full leg. Shalom, shalom.